We begin with a scathing threat from Israel. Its energy minister says the siege of Gaza will not end until all Israeli hostages are released. In a social media post, Minister Israel Katz said no electrical switch will be turned on and no weather or fuel or water or fuel supply will be allowed in until all captives are free. Most of the 2.3 million people in the Gaza Strip are without power and water as hundreds of Israeli strikes rain down on the tiny enclave. Over 1,100 Palestinians, about half of them children, have been killed in the Blitz. The death toll in Israel stands at over 1,200. Around 100 hostages were taken into Gaza during Hamas's deadly attacks over the weekend. 22 Filipinos in southern Israel near the Gaza Strip are requesting repatriation. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department says it is coordinating with various government agencies to assist Filipinos caught in the conflict. The DMW is also working on the repatriation of the remains of two Filipinos who died in the war. Meanwhile, the Philippine Air Force says it is ready to deploy its assets for repatriation efforts. Two aircraft with crew, medical personnel, and security personnel are ready to fly out as soon as directed.
We are down to three OFWs whose status still would need updating. We would still need to obtain the status of these three OFWs. So for the most part, we've accounted for everyone who had requested for assistance.
A Filipino caregiver in Israel is appealing for help after armed men allegedly raided her employer's home last October 7. Camille Gisalva said she hid in a bomb shelter with her 95-year-old patient who has Alzheimer's disease. Gisalva shared photos of the house in disarray. She's currently in a hotel in Jerusalem and is seeking aid from the Philippine Embassy.
The Philippine Information and Technology Department also saying the data breach at the PSA is not as sophisticated as the attack on PhilHealth. According to DICT Undersecretary Jeffrey D, initial investigations showed the hackers are likely based in the Philippines. D adds his agency still hopes to receive an intelligence fund to uncover any other possible data breach. Earlier this week, an ad hoc House committee stripped the DICT of its confidential fund for next year.
Sa ngayon, ang alam namin ay yung nakompromiso ay yung laman ng community-based monitoring system. At nandito po, sinasubmit ang kanilang mga regional offices yung mga survey form. So ibig sabihin, nung household survey, nung papasok ang mga taga-PSA, magtatanong ng mga impormasyon sa iyo. Sino ang head of the family, ilan kayo, ano income ninyo, no, mga ganon.
A cybersecurity advocacy group urges lawmakers to allocate more funds to government agencies to help them combat cyber attacks. Ronald Gustilo of Digital Pinoy says the recent data breach in PhilHealth and the PSA show cybersecurity is not a state priority. He adds the ICT department should set standards for cybersecurity infrastructure across all government agencies. Gustilo also believes the government should also compensate victims of the data leaks.
I think the current, the recent incidents of data breaches is an eye-opener for all of us now. Kasi it truly shows the current state of our cybersecurity infrastructure here in our country, especially for our government, that it seems that it's not among the priorities of the government. So I think it's high time that the government spends more of its budget to protect the data of the public. I'm really hoping that this is the last of it. But then again, knowing how the internet works and how technology works, this could not be the last. But since the budget deliberations is still not over, maybe our good senators and our good congressmen can compel these agencies and maybe they can allocate more budgets for critical agencies that are holding huge amounts of data to undertake to procure cybersecurity infrastructure to implement stiffer cybersecurity measures to protect our data. Kasi if they will not do that, if these agencies won't do that, eh talagang this would not be the last of it.
An opposition House lawmaker wants President Marcos to give up a portion of his confidential and intelligence funds for 2024. Congressman Edsel Lagman wonders whether Marcos would voluntarily relinquish some of his funds following a similar move by the offices of the Ombudsman and the Solicitor General. The Office of the President is seeking 4.5 billion pesos in confidential funds for next year.
The Immigration Bureau eyes using body cameras to address rising complaints against their personnel. Immigration spokesperson Dana Sandoval says the agency is in the process of procuring the body cameras, which screening officers can use by the end of the year.
Meron pong live streaming feature para namomonitor po ng office ni Commissioner what's actually happening on the ground. And maiiwasan po natin yung mga complaints about illegal actions, halimbawa ng mga employees o kaya naman po yung hindi mabuting pakikitungo ng ating mga empleyado.
The agency has also resumed the procurement of electronic gates for use in the country's international airports.